Hi, I'm Tyler Dynocki, and welcome to Art After Dark, a show where I'm going to teach you how to create simple and beautiful paintings right from the comfort of your own home. The painting that we're going to do today is this awesome kind of cherry blossom tree, big bright background, flowers. We're going to learn how to make all that and create branches. Branches sometimes scare people, but it's really easy to do. We just have to kind of walk our way through it. The paints that we're going to use today is an indigo. We're going to use a yellow and a red to create some really neat greens against that blue. We have a pink, and then we want a brown. We have a fluid black and a white. The brushes that we're going to use is a 3/4 inch wash brush. We have a number 4 bright, and then we're just going to use a number 2 round. So think big, medium, small. We don't need much for this painting. And then you're going to want water, a plate to put your paints on, and paper towel in case you make a mess and dry off your brushes. So let's paint. So the first step that we're going to do for the cherry blossom tree painting is we want to build our background. Again, we have that indigo color, a white, a yellow, and a little bit of black. That's all we're going to use to make the background. When we mix a little bit of the blue and the yellow together, we're going to get a green. So we're just going to grab a little bit of water. We're going to use our wash brush. We're going to use him for the whole background, and we're going to just grab a bunch of blue. Let's start in the top left corner. Now while we're developing this, we want to make sure that our brush is actually moving all over the place. We don't want to sit there and just go in one direction. We want to have it kind of mixing in so we can't see the direction all the time. Now I'm going to do a little bit of blue, and then I'm going to grab just a little bit of white and start adding it in there too, so that we get some neat stuff happening. So start adding in a little bit of white. And you can push your brush into the canvas as well. That'll help fill in some of the little pits. I'm going to work this down. So maybe that's a little lighter there. I might come in with a little bit of dark paint in this area. But you want to stay kind of moving in one direction again. Sorry, across the canvas. You don't want to jump from here to down here to here, because you want to work with the paint while it's still wet. And there, I just grabbed a whole bunch of white there. I can move that around for a while. And drop that down. And I might just kind of see how I'm kind of coming back to the paint areas that I already did, just to kind of mix it in to the new stuff as it gets to sit for a little bit. Okay, so right about here, I'm going to come in and I'm going to add in a little bit of yellow. I'm going to add some white to it, and this is where we're going to get that really cool subtle green happening. So I'm just going to plop that in there, and I'm going to add some white. And then you'll see that it'll start to punch through. A little bit of blue, a little bit more yellow, and there we have the green that comes right in. Now see, I'm working the edge right between those two areas. You do short little strokes, but notice how my brush keeps moving all over the place, right? I'm not staying with one kind of direction with that brush. Now, maybe I'll lighten this up a little bit more down here. And if you're using a tabletop easel, it's a good idea to hold onto the bottom of it so that you don't knock it over on you, especially if you're being a little aggressive with your brush. Push it into the canvas a bit. There, so I really like how that's turning out right now. We're getting a whole bunch of stuff. Let's bring that dark blue back into the picture. So I'm just grabbing it raw, not mixing any colors, and blending it into the paint that's kind of sitting there. So I think I might want to keep working on this here. I'm just going to throw in some white and a little bit of yellow right in here. And then I'm going to grab a little bit of that blue to pop that green. I'm gonna bring this right up to the top. Now I might lighten this up a little bit in the middle. So if we're gonna lighten it up, just come grab some white, throw it in there, mix it up. So now you can see how this background's actually really developing against this, in this kind of area. Again, you could jump to like a dark spot, add in a little bit of a lighter spot, throw in the yellow again to make a little bit of green, and you want to develop the whole thing. Sometimes it's nice to come into the corners and make some of the edges a little darker as well. So once you're done your background, we're going to jump into building our cherry blossom branch right across here. So finish that up, and we'll move on to the next step. I finished my background, it's all dry now, and now I'm going to develop the branch. So what I'm going to use for the main branch is that wash brush. That way you could kind of drag it across and get a nice big fill. The interesting thing with these branches is you just don't want to make a big straight line. You want to give it some character, some little bumps, make it come down and go back up, a little bump, and then maybe back down there. So that's all we're going to do. We're going to use this black, and we're going to develop our whole branch. So it's fun just to dive in. I'm gonna start right here, and I'm gonna kind of move across. There's a little bump, and I could come back and thicken it up after too. I'm gonna kind of follow this thing here. Here's another little bump. I'm gonna bring it up, and then I'll kind of bring this down. And notice how I changed the angle of my brush by just turning it, so I got a very thin line. Now I could come back and thicken this up. So, if I'm cutting it in, I might add a little nub down here. Let's make that a little thicker. A little bump there. I'm gonna come up into the top. Let's bring this down. Bring it down this way. Okay, so I'm gonna keep kind of fixing the edges of this. You could come in, use that big brush, fill it up. Notice that I just did the main branch. I wasn't doing all the little branches coming off. I just want to get something happen here so I can visualize what this is going to look like as I'm going. Let's come back and nicely fill these in. And like I said, giving this branch a little character with the little bumpies and stuff is a lot of fun, especially when we come to fill it in with the browns. We're going to get a little bit of color happening. Okay, so there's the first part of that. Now I might come in this area, and I'm just gonna make a branch that comes up. Let's bring it back down this way, and we'll stop there, because we're gonna come back with our round brush and do little tinier branches as we go along. A little bit more details. Let's put one down here. We can make a little thing, and then we'll cut it across, say, that way. And again, I'm gonna come fix it after. Let's do another branch up here, except this guy, I'm gonna kind of make him come up through there, right through the top. Okay, and then I want a longer one. Let's say he comes about underneath here, kind of coming that way. So I'm gonna drag him down. I'm gonna kind of do that with him. There we go. There's a nice, get on a little character there. It's okay. And a couple more. Let's do one off the top here. In the bigger area, bring him up. Bam. And then one more. Right underneath there, a little tiny guy. Okay. So that's the kind of start of my branches. I'm gonna switch brushes right now. I'm gonna switch to a round guy. I'm gonna start developing this. So, let's start on him. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna use a little water, and if you curl your brush on your palette, just give it a little twist, it helps all the little bristles come into place. So a little trick when I'm doing branches too, is that I'll do like a two to one ratio. I'll go one branch, and then I'll break it off into another one. So from here, we'll say that this is one, I'll come from here and do another one. And then from here, let's do one from here. Notice as I'm coming in to the bigger branch, I'm actually applying a little bit more pressure. That's making the brush fan out, which I can get a nice little line. If I want to come from, or leave from inside the branch, I kind of want a little bit of a follow through so that I get a nice sharper tip. So I'll come from inside here, and I'll walk, and a little bit of a follow through. So that's one branch. Now I'm gonna go two. And then from this one, I'm gonna go two. From here, I could go another one, two. Let's try from here. We're gonna finish up this area. Maybe one more little branch coming off of here somewhere, probably here. I'm gonna bring him right up and out. And then let's give him a buddy. Little buddy. There we go. I'm gonna bring him in. We'll give him a buddy. And same with this guy. There. See how I just give it a little wiggle? Little wiggle, and you get a little bit of character to it. Now that got a little thick on me, so I might wanna thicken it up on the branch where it attaches to the main part. Okay, let's give him a little buddy in here too. See, so that's just kinda how you're starting to develop these branches. After you do the little 2-to-1 ratio, you can start adding a little bit more tiny branches here and there, and you could bring little longer ones across. So this is, I'm gonna do this one because he's a little different. He comes down. So what I'm gonna do is kind of attach this, bring that up, so it's almost like a little elbow. Then I'm going to give him another little buddy coming this way. Pushing him down, oops, you'll load him up again. Pushing him down, and then the follow through. Same with that. Okay, and then in here I might give it another branch. And remember the 2-to-1 ratio thing. I might even give it a tiny little guy down here. And how about something like that? So you can see how you start to develop that. It starts to look really neat. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna keep developing these branches. Remember, you know, one branch and then two branch and then another one. Each branch that you make kind of come off of it, different directions. It doesn't all have to be straight either. You can give it a little curvature to it and move it around. So keep on developing your branches. Then we're gonna come back and start doing highlights and everything inside of that big branch and the little guys. I'm sitting with Tony, and this is where we're at right now. You have this awesome tree. I love your background. You have a really nice wash right through it. And your tree's wicked too. It has so much character to it, which I love. Did you enjoy doing like the little branches and everything?
Yeah, the branches is pretty fun. I like the background.
Everyone likes backgrounds because they're kind of like free. You just go at it, have fun, mix all your colors up. And everybody's background is super different too, which is a really neat part. So every painting looks really, really different. Well, it's looking good up to now. A couple more steps.
Let's do it.
Okay. Right. I finished all of my branches. I came in and did a whole bunch of little guys off of the big ones. Remember, we did that little 2-to-1 kind of ratio thing. So our next step we're going to do is we're going to start highlighting our branch and our tree there. So I'm going to use a little bit of this brown, and we're just going to put it on. And while I'm doing it, I'm going to kind of give it a little bit of curves. I'm going to move it around. And it's really messy. We're not going in and painting like bark as we're doing this. We're just kind of highlighting things. So I'm going to start right in here. I'm just going to kind of do a little bit of a brown. And then if you wanted it a little lighter, just use some white. And you can start to add in a little bit of that too. So I'm just going to move down the branch and start applying this to it. If you want it darker, add a little black. So we're just going to start to make this. Notice how I'm kind of moving it around. Nothing too crazy. I'm just gonna come in one color, kind of move it around, come on these branches here. We'll move to our little guy when we start doing the branches up there. Right now it's looking kind of like a tiger, which is okay. Now I'm gonna grab a bit of black, I'm gonna make a darker brown, and kind of put that in the middle here. There we go. So I'm gonna drag him in a bit. I'm gonna highlight this with white after too. There we go. Okay. So, again, I'm just kind of moving around. We'll come back to the little guy to get the details in these. So I'm kind of happy with that. Now I'm gonna do some light highlights. I'm gonna grab some white, a little bit of brown, and then we're gonna add this in. There we go. So that really starts to punch this out a bit. I'm just being really random with it. Super cool. I just love how that starts to look once you start applying it. Makes everything come to life. Maybe a couple more in here. There. Okay, now I'm gonna switch over to my round brush and I'm going to do the same idea in the little branches here. So we could just start, I'm not gonna do like curve it around, I'm just gonna follow inside of the brush or the branch a bit just to give it a little bit of color. Kind of same with here, I might touch up on that. Bring some of that in, let's do this guy. So I might bring some of that brown down. And some in this guy. And some up in here. It's really fast. We don't have to sit too long on this thing because it's just kind of random. Sometimes the neatest stuff happens when you just give her. You don't think about it too much. Okay, so I'm kind of, I might get this part in here a little bit. Now after I'm done that, I'm gonna come back to my white. And I'm gonna highlight some of the little branches, make them pop out a bit. There's my white. Start here. So I might come in here and I'm just gonna do a little bit of stuff. Right on the top. Same with this one. Let's do some on that little knuckle there. You can see that looks really neat. We got a lot of character coming out of this. And I'm just very easily just applying it in random spots. And then here, ooh, that was nice. Do this little nubbin in there, fill that in. Okay, I finished all my details in the branches. I used that brown, the white, got all the little highlights, and when I was done, I was like, that looks pretty good. So now we're gonna jump to doing the flowers. Flowers are, they're pretty easy to do, actually. We're not gonna like paint each petal. What we're gonna do is use our bright brush. And you could change it up too. You can use a round brush, make some smaller ones. And all we're gonna do is load up the brush, a little bit of white, some pink I'm using there, and I'm just gonna load it up. I'm just gonna get some paint on it, so it's really random. And I'm gonna make one right here. So what you wanna do is you're coming in, you're gonna push down on one side, then I'm gonna change the angle of my brush, and push down on the other, I'm gonna change the angle again, I'm gonna push down, and then I'm gonna change it again. So one, two, three, four. Afterwards, we're gonna come in and fill the centers with a little bit of black so it looks like a little seed area. And we're just gonna keep developing a bunch of flowers all over this thing. So I'm gonna mortar and show you how to kind of create these. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Now I might want a darker one, so I'll grab more pink instead this time. I'll do one up here. One, two, three, and we'll go four. Let's do that again. Maybe one in here. One, two, three, four. How about here? One, two, three, four. And just keep following your branches a little bit. That looks awesome. Maybe one up in here. I could do a little guy. Three, four. So I eased up a little bit on the brush. I didn't push it down as hard. Three, four, bam. Okay, so once I get a certain area done, I'm going to want to do just some individual flowers. So let's say that I have this happening. I'm happy with all my flowers. Remember, you want to fill each branch up. All of them. You're gonna do a lot of flowers. Lots of them. Oops, I hit my easel there. So I'm gonna fix that up a bit. That's a fiver. Yeah. Okay, one, two, three, four. Now, what I want to do is come in, and on the branches, I'm going to grab some white, and I'm just going to do some like little tiny little buds on the branches. I'm going to kind of fill them up a bit. Just by kind of filling the area. There we go, keep filling it. And you can even have some kind of in the middle of your painting so it looks like they're blowing in the wind or something. So little tiny dots, and I'm just loading up the brush. I'm not mixing it, because then you can have the paint kind of roll into each other, and that'll look really neat. You follow the branch, maybe load up an area like that, like some petals are floating on this little tree there. Okay, so I'm gonna keep doing that for a little bit. Once you have, you're comfortable with what you have, you could come back and grab your black and just come into the middle of these guys. Just give them a little center. Just a little dot right in the middle. I'm gonna hit this guy. There. So they're fairly easy to do. And I'm gonna create a little bit more. One, well, I'm gonna load this up. One, two, three, four, five. How about this guy? One, two, three, four. Bam. So let's finish up all of these flowers. Remember, you wanna fill each branch. You can do small ones, you can do big ones. Then we're gonna jump to your round brush, and we're gonna fill some of the end of the branches so it looks like little flower buds. You can have some flowers, some petals kind of resting on top of the branch. And don't forget, you can make it kind of flowing in the wind, so you can put it in the negative space all in here, some little dots. So we're gonna keep on doing this, and then we'll be right back. Finished all my flowers, and now I'm just coming in and doing a little bit of these dots, some of these flower buds. I'm gonna fill up these little branches here. Remember to, you know, put a couple in the negative space so it looks like some of these petals are flying through the air. You can give them a little angle and everything like that. All the little flowers too, I gave them little black dots. And then I'm just gonna grab a little bit of white. Maybe add some of that to some of the buds on the end. That'll kind of pop it out a bit. Same with up in here, a little bit more. Actually, I really like that against the pink. Looks really nice. And then when you're feeling like you don't know where to put any more, oh, I found a spot. That'll happen. Sometimes you'll find a spot, you just gotta hit it. Load that up. There we go. And I think that we are about, wait for it, done. Okay, I'm standing with Leah here, and this is her finished product. I think you did an amazing job.
Thank you.
And I do love like the exaggeration of the big to small kind of thing. totally reminds me of that author that wrote about the hat in a cat thing.
It felt natural.
It did, probably, right? You just have fun, and that's the coolest part. How'd you like doing the flowers?
Oh, it was fun.
Yeah.
All of it was great. Never done it before, so.
Well, you did a good job. I'm impressed.
I was a little nervous coming into it, but it was a lot of fun.
Yeah, don't be nervous. Don't be nervous. Just do. Yeah.
Got it.
Thank you for coming.
Yes, thank you.
Remember that everybody can paint. You just have to dive into it. I've seen people who've never painted before and just blew my mind away how good they were. And then sometimes you just gotta practice and you get better and better at it. The thing is that you gotta try. So thank you for watching. We'll see you next time on Art After Dark.
Art After Dark is brought to you by JRG Contracting, specializing in custom home renovations in the St. Albert and Greater Edmonton area. JRG Contracting. Art After Dark is filmed in front of a live studio audience at Privada Wine and Tapas. Located in the heart of downtown St. Albert, Privada only uses fresh and local ingredients.